Brose is one of the 5 largest family-owned automotive suppliers in the world. 1 in every 3 new vehicles will have at least one Brose product in it. We do about 7.9 billion euros in turnover. Our customers expect the highest quality standards that we deliver. They also expect short development times, as well as us continuously focusing to integrate innovative technologies into the products to ensure the right part at the right time for the right price at the right cost.
We have seen rapid changes in the automotive industry, especially in the last 5 years. Development times for new products are getting shortened by a lot. That requires us to act accordingly to it. We have to implement additive technology more and more. It's in our interest because it also shortens those lead times for toolings, etc., and helps us later with the production to be a little bit faster in the application. We use 3D printed parts in all our commodities. We act more as a chop shop, which also leads to us printing higher quantities over here. So we will print parts in the hundreds of thousands right now for BMW, as example, for the end use customers, but also do prototyping where we do several hundred parts a week, mostly related to the amount of tests that we have to do. Not only do we fulfill internal and external standards, but also federal requirements, which require from us to do a certain amount of parts. And that usually leads into 700 to 800 parts that we have to print for a prototype. 3D printing has a lot of use cases for us here, especially in the prototype shop. We use 3D printing to make us jigs, to make assemblies easier, to position certain parts in right locations, but also to set up our weld stations. We implement those parts into our weld fixtures to be able to program the robot ahead of having actual metal stamped parts. This is definitely speeding up our process and helps us to gain necessarily time. Brose is using additive technology to be more agile in the production. In our new Boston location specifically, we use 3D printed manufacturing aids. We use them for connectors like wear and tear parts to allow us quicker repairs on the production line, as well as avoiding downtime in the production. We do have more and more customers requesting additive technology because the end use customer would like to have more personalization in their vehicles, and therefore additive technology is being asked more and more. When we brought the fuse technology and the SLS technology in-house, we wanted to produce more on a serial production level with higher quantities. The fuse actually allows us to do so. Changeover is quick, printing on several build chambers is allowed, so we can produce greater amount of quantities, which allows us to use it for gap printing. We consider gap printing the time between having a tool ready and the design change to be implemented. This makes the technology way more interesting for end-use customers and was a decision for BMW to give us the go-ahead to use additive technology as a resource to provide the necessary design change right away instead of delaying the process and waiting for toolings, etc.
We have FDM printers, we have SLS printers, and we also have SLA printers. We look to SLA printers for quick turnover, really quick print times, quick ability to change the materials over. We use a range of different materials for different applications, and we can go from one material to the next within minutes. When we got into 3D printing, we had a lot of trouble getting large serial production total, but with our SLS printers, we've really upscaled and we now produce enough parts to hit our serial production quantities.
For the BMW project, we have to print 250,000 clips in a period of 6 months.
We do this by printing nonstop, 24 hours. We're printing about 1,440 per print.
Brose decided to bring SLS with Formlabs in-house because SLS technology allows us a fast and rapid printing that also has less post-processing requirements as we see on SLA. We noticed that we can print higher volume quantities, which is necessary for us to support especially gap printing or any other OEM-related end customer parts. This leads to more and more use cases in the automotive industry.